Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Maricel. I make videos about my immigration journey moving here in the US. I also started doing some vlogs here and there and some unboxing. If you are interested into this type of video, I would really love for you to hit the subscribe button down below. And don't forget to hit that notification bell so you will be notified whenever I upload new videos just like this one. And so for today's video, I will be sharing to you my father's visa interview at the U.S. Embassy Manila that took place last September 27th of 2020. He went for his IR5 visa interview. I will be sharing to you his visa interview experience and also the questions that he was asked during his interview. And of course, what were the documents that the U.S. Embassy Manila had asked my father to bring during his interview. So if you have not watched my video about how I submitted my application for expedite processing for my father's IR5 or I-130 petition, I will link it down below in the description box. And also, I will be making the playlist about my father's I-130 petition journey here in my channel, so look that up into my playlist section. September 27th of 2022, my father went to the U.S. Embassy Manila for his visa interview. That day, it was around 6:30 in the morning. There has been so many struggles since there was a typhoon going on in Manila, and we were all the way from Davao, so it was just a mess and a half overall. Like, there were so many interviews that Monday. His interview was Tuesday. Monday, I know there were some people that had to reschedule the visa interview schedule because they couldn't make it to the U.S. Embassy Manila because they're from, you know, different provinces. But thankfully, my father was scheduled Tuesday. Though his flight was late, he was still able to make it to his flight and made it to his visa interview on the 27th of September. Once he was entering the embassy, he was asked for his appointment letter and I think the passport. The U.S. Embassy Manila will be sending you an email of the checklist of the documents that you have to bring during your interview. So yeah, my father went in and got checked and everything. He gave his appointment letter and his passport and he was scanned and everything. I asked my father and he said during the interview, he was only asked 4 questions, and those were, what's your name, which is what's my father's name, what's your daughter's name, where were you born, they're asking where was my father born, and where was your daughter born, and pretty much that's it. Like, he was just asked 4 questions, and before he went to the interview, I told him literally every single thing, like, Dad, make sure you know my address, you know what type of job I do, you know how many children I have, you know how many people in my household have. So literally every single thing, and when did I move here in the US, and all that stuff. And so he was like kind of panicking and whatnot, but thankfully, he was only asked 4 questions. It was very easy for him being asked with just those 4 questions. There was a time where he was asked to step out the embassy, and the consul wrote a letter or wrote a note that says, like, call your daughter or text your daughter or message your daughter that she has to update the number of children you have in your DS-260. Because for some reason, I only put 4 children over there. There are 5 of us, but for some reason, I don't know why I put 4, but it was so nice of her to let my father step out and contact me to update that DS-260, save it and sign it. And so my father didn't have to go for another visa interview for that. And so that was very nice of them to do. My father's DS-260 has his old passport, so what I could not update that because it happened so quickly. Like, the visa scheduling happened so quickly to where when I asked to get his DS-260 reopened, they were not able to respond to me on time. So what we did is I asked my father to bring his old passport together with his new passport, and I told him to tell the consul that the passport number that he have on his DS-260 is an old passport number. So they were able to update that, thankfully, on their end, and I was able to update the number of children, which the only missing children over there on his DS-260 is me. So I added myself in his DS-260, and it was very easy. They reopened it. Again, I logged into my SIAC account, and then they reopened it, and I was able to edit the DS-260. One thing about DS-260 is that you could not edit that after you saved, submitted, and signed it for the very first time. So once you signed it, that's it. The only way to get it reopened is when you request them or you send a request to the U.S. Embassy Manila to get your DS-60 reopened and updated. So, yeah, they were able to reopen my account, and I was able to edit it the same day of his appointment. And then after like 15 minutes or so, my father went back again inside to continue in his interview. But he said he was just sitting there for like 2 hours, literally waiting for the consul to come back and tell him what's the results. And yeah, thankfully, they took my father's passport and they congratulated my father that he passed the interview, and he would need to leave the Philippines before October 27th, or else he will have to go for another medical examination, which we're not gonna do. So my father was like, I am for sure I will be leaving Philippines before October 27th. And he was very excited knowing that he passed the interview. Just to give you a background, my father tried to apply for a tourist visa 3 times, and those 3 attempts were all denied. So imagine this experience for him. It must be very fulfilling, you know, like to me alone, it's very fulfilling. This is something that I have been waiting for so long. I've been dreaming for since literally the day I got here in the US, to be able to bring my parents in here. Though my mom is not able to because she's already passed away, at least I have my father, you know. I was able to give that to my father. 4 days before my father's U.S. visa interview, the U.S. Embassy Manila sent us an email of the checklist of the documents that my father needs to bring during his visa interview. And I will be sharing that to you right now. Let me pull that up real quick. This is how that email reads like. Congratulations, our office is ready to begin the final processing of your immigrant visa application. You should follow all the interview preparation instructions located on the embassy's website. Please scan the QR code below for more information. Please note that no other applicants or petitioners will be allowed entry. Derivative beneficiaries of the visa petition under 14 years old do not require an in-person interview or a personal appearance at the U.S. Embassy unless specifically required. Parents or an authorized guardian of these children should bring the required documentation on their behalf. Marked below are the requirements needed for your visa application. Number 1, your form DS-260. This is for the immigrant visa applicants. If you are a non-immigrant applicant, I think you will have to fill up the form DS-160. And then the medical examination. So my father already went for his medical examination. So St. Luke's already sent my father's medical examination results to the U.S. Embassy prior to his visa interview. And then next is the valid passport. Your passport must be valid for 6 months beyond your intended date of entry into the United States. You must also bring your expired passport with the U.S. with valid U.S. visa if applicable. My father has not ever had any U.S. visa in the past, but still he brought his old passport with him. Photographs. You should bring 2 identical color photographs for each applicant, which must meet the general photograph requirements found in our website. So it's just the 2x2 picture. I know there's a photo booth when I went before at the U.S. Embassy, but if you can get that done already before going to your interview, that would be much better. For civil documents, original documents must be presented at the time of your interview appointment. Copies will not be accepted. For my civil documents, we submitted the PSA birth certificates for both my father and I. We also submitted the proof of marriage termination or proof of marriage. My mom passed away already, so he brought my mom's death certificate. Police clearance issued by the National Bureau of Investigation, or NBI, for applicants who are 16 years old and above. The NBI clearance must include all the names you have used, aliases, or also known as. So my father had to get another NBI certificate since the one that we submitted during the NBC stage has already expired. I think it only lasts for 6 months. So we made sure to renew it and get another one, and so he was able to bring an updated version of that. And also, I had to update my SEAC account for that new NBI. And then they also said military or police service records, if applicable. My father has not served in the military or in the police service in the past, so we didn't have to comply to that requirement. For the affidavit of support forms and financial documents, these are the documents that's coming from me here in the US. Some of these were just scanned and sent to the Philippines and or emailed via PDF and they just printed it out. But my W-2s were original, except my 2001 W-2s that I just had to scan and send to them, since I just filed taxes this year and I already sent the old W-2s for 2020 and 2019 to the Philippines last May, I guess. So for the affidavit of support forms and financial documents, the first on the list would be signed form I-864, or the signed form I-864 affidavit of support. So you have to make sure that you check every single box of this thing, because I'm gonna tell you this, I left two boxes emptied that should not be left emptied. And I just realized the very last minute when I was checking my father's requirements or documents. But thankfully, I was able to reach out to one of the member at the I-130 filing group that I joined on Facebook, and I was able to ask her some questions. And then she said, sis, just go ahead and fill up another one and make sure it's the updated version of your I-864, because the I-864 that I have on my SEAC account was already expired last 9/31 September 31st of 2021, and obviously it's already 2022. So I was like, sis, how am I supposed to bring this to the Philippines, because the US embassy is asking for original copies. And then she said, with our experience in the past, they accepted just a scanned copy and have your father print it over there in the Philippines. But before talking to her, I was already in the verge of booking a flight to the Philippines, because I badly need to make sure that my father would not miss that appointment, because his medical will expire on October 27th. And God forbid, if he did not pass that interview because of this, I would really feel so bad. So I was like, should I just book a plane ticket to the Philippines and just send it over there? But thankfully, I was able to talk to her, and she told me that scanned copy of an updated I-864 is okay, no problem. And so I did that. I made sure to double check every single boxes in there, and really, like, I checked it 10 times before I scanned and uploaded it into my SEAC account. So yeah, make sure you sign that form also. And then the latest form 1040 and W-2 from your petitioner. So in my case, I've already sent my 2019 and 2022, the original copies of those. I already sent it to my father, uploaded it and everything to my SEAC account. I just had to send my 2021 tax forms or 2021 W-2s to him, because he didn't have that. Scanned copy was okay. And of course, the latest tax transcript from your petitioner. So my tax transcript. Also, in that email, they will also give you the website to where you could download your tax transcript on the irs.gov website. So if you need that website, I will also be linking it down in the description box below. So also, guys, all of these documents I will be listing down in the description box, so you will have so you can have that copy. And also, for general reminders, they also said that all applicants must complete the online application form at the seac.state.gov prior to the visa interview, and must bring a printed copy of the DS-260 or DS-160 confirmation page at the time of your interview appointment. Applicants who appear for an interview without a completed application form will be advised to reschedule the interview by visiting the online appointment site, which I will be putting in the description box below, or by calling the Visa Information and Appointment Service at 632-779-28988 or 632-8548-8223. So if you need to update any item, please reach out to us directly through the usembassy.gov contact us visa to reopen the application form prior to the interview. Passports must be valid for 6 months beyond the intended date of entry into the United States. If your case is under electronic document processing, you must scan and upload the requirements listed above and submit into the SIAC portal prior to your visa interview. The documents must be labeled accordingly and uploaded in the appropriate category. Please see scanning and uploading instructions attached. You must also bring the original copies of the civil documents that you have uploaded at the time of your interview. Copies of civil documents will not be accepted. If you will bring a copy of your W-2, that's okay. But if you will bring just a photocopy of your PSA birth certificate, it's not going to work. So you have to make sure that your civil documents are in original form. They also have an important reminder. If your civil documents, affidavit of support forms, and financial documents of your sponsors are incorrectly uploaded or not uploaded into the SIAC portal at the time of your visa interview, your appointment may be delayed or canceled. So yeah, and then they also sent us the QR code for their website to check every single thing prior to going to your visa appointment. That's it for my father's visa update. And to cut it short, he was able to pass his interview and he went September 27th of 2022. He was advised to wait for his passport to be sent back to him a week or two from the day of his interview. So actually, we already got an email from the U.S. Embassy Manila the following day showing the instructions on when to expect and what to do once you received your passport from the courier. So I will be also making a video update once we receive that. So I think that's it for today's update about my father's I-130 or IR-5 visa interview at the U.S. Embassy Manila. So if you do have any questions, please comment down in the description box below. I hope I was able to cover everything about his I-130 visa interview. And like I said, if you have any inquiries or anything that I could help you out information-wise, but just a quick disclaimer, I'm not a lawyer, I'm not an immigrant attorney, or I don't work in any type of field related to immigration. So this is just plainly my own experience and my journey petitioning my father, and that's basically it. So if you did find this video helpful, I would really love for you to hit that like button down below, as it might help me with my YouTube algorithm. And thank you so much for watching in today's video. Till next time, peace. I really want to go to the Philippines and pick up my father, but it's always busy.